Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. We suggest that viewers who are sensitive to the life sciences have an adult watch this video first, to be sure it's suitable for that viewer. Please also read our warning about doing experiments, since we will be demonstrating an experiment in this video. If you've not already done so, we recommend that you watch the videos on plant adaptive traits in Part 2 of Animal Adaptive Traits before watching this video. This basket has 6 different types of fruit, yet each was grown in the same garden, so received the same amount of sunlight, nutrients, and water. The reason these fruits are different from each other is because the plants that grew them used different designs when combining various nutrients. Those designs are written in genes that are carried in each plant's DNA. At the end of this video, we'll demonstrate how to extract pure DNA from strawberries using common household supplies. All animals, plants, and some single-cell organisms, such as bacteria and euglena, are made of cells. A cell is a unit of life that has a specific structure and function. Cells are very tiny, so usually too small to see without a microscope. In this plant leaf, we can see many box shapes. Each of these are cells and are securely attached to its neighbors, which makes this leaf strong. The small green discs are called chloroplasts. They are making sugar by using the energy in sunlight to combine carbon dioxide in the air with water, in a process called photosynthesis. The plant uses that sugar for energy, and can also use that sugar as a building material to make more leaves, stems, or roots. In the background, we can see the flow of water and nutrients through channels called vascular tissue. This is how each cell gets a lot of its nutrients to make products like sugar. Cells also use vascular tissue to send some of the products they've made to the rest of the plant. Each cell has a circular faint disc, which is its nucleus. The nucleus contains the cell's DNA. That DNA directs the cell to take on a specific structure and function. Here's an image of cheek cells that were taken from a person by gently wiping a device on the inside of the mouth. They've been stained with blue dye, so we can see them more easily. Since they've been removed from the cheek, they're not connected to each other in an orderly manner like the plant cells are. But just like the plant cells, we can see that each of these cells is small and has a nucleus. Animals, which includes humans, are much more complicated than plants. So animals have many different cell types. For example, this animation shows nerve cells. They do many things, including let us think and move our arms and legs. Here's a sketch of skin cells showing a slightly different shape and arrangement. But as with nerve cells, they'd also have a nucleus and some other parts in common. Here's a sketch of liver cells. Like the nerve and skin cells, they also have a specific shape, function, nucleus, and other parts in common. These are just a few examples of the many different cell types that make up our different organs. These sketches show an animal cell on the left and a plant cell on the right. Both have a boundary which is like a thin bag called a membrane. The plant cell has an additional lining called the cell wall, which makes plant cells stiff, and is one of the reasons why wood is so strong. The small objects inside the cells are called organelles. Although some organelles are unique to plants or animals, such as the chloroplasts, which we saw earlier in the live plant leaf, many organelles are in both animals and plant cells. The 5 organelles that we'll introduce in greater detail are the nucleus, the mitochondria, the endoplasmic reticulum, the ribosomes, and the Golgi apparatus. All of these structures float inside a liquid that is mostly made of water. Let's pause for a moment, since the vocabulary can be confusing. An organism is an individual animal, plant, or single-cell life form. For example, these are 2 organisms of the giraffe species. An organ is a group of similar cells that work together. The lungs, liver, brain, and stomach are 4 different organs. An organelle is a special object inside a cell, such as those in color in this animation. We can use light microscopes like this one to see cells move and to see some of their organelles. But to see greater details inside a cell, we use a much bigger instrument called an electron microscope. An electron microscope can produce images like this that show the insides of organelles. These organelles are called mitochondria. They're involved in converting sugar into an energy form that the cell can use. We often call mitochondria the cell's powerhouse. Near the center of the cell is the nucleus. That's where DNA is stored. DNA is the blueprint that is used to design the cell's parts. The remaining 3 organelles we'll introduce help build parts the cell needs to do its job. The word protein is the word we use in cell biology that is similar to our everyday word part. By making the right type and number of proteins, a cell becomes the right size, shape, and gets the right equipment to do its job. The organelles used to make and transport proteins are the ribosomes, the endoplasmic reticulum, and the Golgi apparatus. In this image, we can see the nucleus and endoplasmic reticulum are next to each other. There are many tiny dots scattered over the endoplasmic reticulum, of which we have put arrows next to just a few. Those dots are ribosomes. A ribosome is similar to a 3D printer, because both ribosomes and 3D printers can make objects that are any shape based on any design they are given. For example, let's say we made this design on our computer. Now, we can send a copy of this design to a 3D printer, and in a little while we'll be able to hold this object. Like a 3D printer, once the ribosome gets a copy of a design, it will make an object based on that design. The design sent to the ribosome is a copy of some DNA, and the object the ribosome makes is called a protein. As these ribosomes make a protein, they put it into the endoplasmic reticulum. After that, the protein goes into the Golgi apparatus, which is like a taxi service, for moving the protein to the correct part of the cell. You can remember this because the first two letters spell GO, and this organelle helps the protein go where it is needed. The Golgi apparatus can even release the new protein from the cell into blood vessels, so the protein can be used by other parts of the body. Next, we'll talk about cell replication. To grow and repair our bodies, we need new cells. A typical adult has over 30 trillion cells. To make more cells, our cells divide in half, then each half grows back to the original size. Then those new cells can also divide, and this process continues to repeat as needed. This process is called mitosis. To extract DNA from strawberries, we start by mashing two strawberries in a plastic bag. Then we add 5 milliliters of salt and 10 milliliters of liquid soap to 120 milliliters of water. Then we pour that solution into the bag containing the mashed strawberries. We gently mix the bag's contents for a few minutes. During this process, the cell membranes are broken apart by the soap. Next, we pour this mixture into a coffee filter and wait for the liquid to drip through. Then we add 120 milliliters of cold isopropyl alcohol, commonly called rubbing alcohol, to the filtered solution. Almost immediately, a white solid forms on the top of this liquid. That's the strawberry's DNA. In less than 5 minutes, the DNA is isolated and we can pick it up. Here's a summary of this topic. Please pause this video if you wish to read this. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.